Michael Rapaport. So, Michael, do you think these two will end up together with the Knicks?
Well, first of all, not only am I a great trash talker and, uh-huh. and you know sports commentary guy, mm-hmm. I'm a fantastic lip reader.
Oh, good.
And he said, they didn't say two and Max. He goes, two, you guys, relax. That's
oh.
what, that's
oh.
what, yeah, he said, you guys relax. And he was talking to all of us. Yeah. Now, listen, what I love, do I think, do I imagine, do I lay my head on the mm-hmm. pillow dreaming that Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant would come to the Knicks with max deals and sign for 3 years and get us that parade down Fifth mm-hmm. Avenue? Yes, I would love that. That would be such a beautiful way to end this rocky road that we've been on since 1973.
1973.
Dude, but does that make me sleep well, thinking that it's definitely going to happen? Mm. Absolutely not. Mm. I have no idea. Yes, I would love it, but I don't know. Boston might, you know, tighten up the screws and go for a championship mm-hmm. run. Does he leave after that? I don't know. My prediction has always been that Kevin Durant will more likely leave Golden State if the Golden State Warriors win. I cannot see Kevin Durant leaving the Golden State Warriors if they lose because of all the scrutiny that he took the last time he left a team. Mm-hmm. So, of course, I would love it. Mm. Of course, it would be fantastic, especially with that young talent and the David Fizdale, who I think is getting the most out of that young talent.
He is, yeah.
And a potential Duke player coming to us and maybe another ancillary player. Mm-hmm. I would love it, Skip. Mm-hmm. But I can't say I rest my head on the pillow going, oh, it's going to happen. This is going to be great. I toss and turn. I don't rest easy about this whole thing. So I don't know. But as far as lip reading, he said, you guys relax.
You guys relax.
Yes.
So I thought before the All-Star game, this was going to happen. It just felt right. And I know there's much to be played out. Golden State, what happens there? What happens to Kyrie in Boston this year in this playoff run? Jason Tatum at the All-Star game, he just flat out went right on the record and said, on February 16th, I predict we are going to win the NBA championship. That's what he said. Boston Celtics. And I think the last time I checked, Kyrie's going to have to be part of that. Now, to what I saw on Sunday night in Charlotte, that felt staged to me.
Yes.
That felt like they were playing it for the media because Kevin is sick and tired, as I call him, Kevin Durant, because he do rant. And he ranted and ranted and ranted about this, what was it, 2 weeks ago?
Yes.
And I think they conspired to put on a post-game show that would relight all the fires about Kyrie and Kevin are going to New York. And it was odd to me that right after the game, just as soon as it ended, and I'm just watching via TNT, but I see Kyrie and Kevin yucking it up on the court. They went right to each other, and they're kind of playfully shoving each other, yep. playing around. And then all of a sudden, it's time for the MVP celebration, and who's going to win it? And I was pretty sure the best player on the planet is going to win. It's Kevin Durant, who took over yet another fourth quarter. So he is called up front and center. He wins the award. It's presented, and everybody applauds. And then as they continue to talk, and he does his little interview with the commissioner, and all of a sudden everybody thins out and goes to their family and friends. And one guy was left clapping right behind Kevin Durant, and it was Kyrie. He's clapping by himself. And I'm thinking, what are you doing? You're putting on a show. This is staged. And then they go up in the tunnel, and now this viral video has occurred. Because they have decided, let's just play with everybody. Let's have fun with everybody because we will go viral on the internet. But yet again, I thought going into the weekend, I thought this really was happening.
Both of them?
I believe Kevin Durant for sure would love to play in New York. And again, this has been the year that like, I've never seen anything quite like this year for your building. Your building is Madison Square Garden. It is called the Mecca of basketball.
World's most famous arena. Okay?
It is. And yet, you haven't won a championship there since 1973. But what keeps happening night after night after visiting team night? Whoever, it's Dirk's last game at Madison Square Garden. It's James Harden. It's Steph Curry. Every visitor who goes into that building wants to put on the show of shows. So that's all you've had since 1973 is that the world wants to own your arena, right? but that's still pretty cool. And I think Kevin Durant is saying to himself, I would like to put on a show of shows every night for 41 games a year, 41 regular season games a year in that building. I would like to try to win a championship in the Big Apple, okay? And Kyrie grew up partially, spent some in Australia, but partially he went to high school in New Jersey.
Yeah.
And I think his father has Knicks in his blood, right?
Rod Strickland is a godfather.
Okay, you got it.
Great Nick, New York player.
Great Nick. And so the bloodlines channeled that way for Kyrie. So it just seems right that if, in fact, they can fit two max under their cap, that would be a great move for both of them, depending on how the rest of the season plays out. Because the dominoes haven't started falling. And if the dominoes fall the wrong way, if Golden State falls on its face because Kevin and Draymond have fallen out, which is possible, then maybe Kevin decides, I don't know, like he needs to right the wrong and stay in Golden State for another year.
Listen, being a Knicks fan has been so brutal. You know, this Porzingis character, that guy, the way
unicorn.
He left.
We didn't bring it up. Yeah, you did.
Yeah, yeah, him. I mean, everything. And then yesterday, they're selling the Knicks, and then they're not. We're comfortably, reluctantly numb at this point.
You are.
But Kevin Durant coming, it would look beautiful, too. Because, you know, he's tall, thin-shouldered, beautiful like the Empire State Building. We put him up there on there. It would look beautiful. We've never had a star like him.
We want it for you, Michael. Yeah. We want it for you.
And it's not just me. I'm just a vessel for the rest.
He speaks for everyone. Thank you for being here today. Always good to have you. Is Antonio Brown officially done in Pittsburgh? We've got breaking news next. We got to get everyone's take coming up.